Welcome back again for the 3-2-1 Live Limitless show. And today we are going to live a limitless life with Zarina Poonawalla. Zarina is an expert, she is a coach. So let me introduce Zarina. She is a peak performance coach. And she's also a life coach, intelligent leadership coach as well, executive coach. She coaches executives around the world. And she's an NLP practitioner, emotional intelligence practitioner, and she also hosts a podcast called The Empowering Series with Zarina Poonawalla, and also another one called Monday Mantras. And Zarina has recently won awards in Women Leadership Contribution and also another award for Mental Health Awareness. Welcome to the show, Zarina. We are so glad to have you here.
Thank you, Ram, and thank you for the wonderful introduction. I'm very, very glad and happy to be on your show today.
Awesome. That was fantastic. And I'm sure we are going to get some real golden nuggets of information and a couple of tools and your insights and perspectives today, because there are some burning questions that are going around, especially, people are so stressed. The world itself is in a very chaotic condition right now. It's not just our city or country. The entire world is, a lot of chaos is happening. And my first question is all about that. How do we deal with stress and anxiety?
Right. So that's a very good question to begin with, because I've been answering this question very often lately. And what I realize is people do get anxious very soon. They get stressed very soon. And of course, the world with this pandemic has put us through a lot of pressure recently. Naturally, we're not equipped to handle this kind of stress. But let me tell you this little bit about stress. Stress is just pressure. Stress is nothing but emphasis. If you put pressure on something, it's called stress. Now, anxiety or anxiousness is one of the reactions that the body has because of that stress, right? So while you may be calm, if you're even stressed out, I may get all hyper and, anxious. The problem with that is that only the body is reacting and there's a physiological change, but mentally, you're not really trying to solve the problem. So a lot of people around us use the words often, but without even realizing what they mean, Ram. The words themselves, you'll see a four-year-old kid stressed out because he or she's supposed to go to school again, right? And you can see somebody in their 15 years of age stressed out because they had a little bit of a heartbreak and their crush has not responded. So stress suddenly seems very different for different people. But the word must not be used as loosely as we use it. It has a meaning. It's a scientific meaning. So as long as people understand that to deal with stress, first, you need to condition your mind a little bit. Think about being a problem solver and not a problem thinker. The minute you do that, half of the issues and the stress-related problems, the pressure you feel, will start loosening up. It will start deflating. And then you will automatically feel less anxious also. So anxiety is a reaction to stress. Everybody's stressed out. But, until and unless we're not stressed out, these days if you go to see, if you go to a ICU and the pandemic is on, as long as you can see that line on the machine going up and down, you're happy. Because the body is under some movement. There is something happening. If it's a straight line, it's no fun. It's the end. So may as well embrace the stress around you, and there's no need to get anxious. If you get anxious, I would suggest do a few deep breathing exercises, keep it easy and start focusing on problem solving instead of problem thinking.
Fantastic. And thank you for sharing this perspective. And I also understand and resonate with you, and the words stress and anxiety are not interchangeable. So one is the cause, the other is the result. That's what I got this from this little
understanding
from your answer. So let me also bring your attention to people. Nowadays, a lot of unemployment, furloughs are going on. People are losing jobs. And there are a lot of job threats which are looming. Like people don't know whether they're going to keep this job this month, or will they be asked to get out of their jobs? Will they have to lose jobs? Will they have to find another job? So what do you think? How should people deal with unemployment and job threats as well?
So Ram, you know, recent studies have shown us, and the things that are going on, the world crisis and the economic crisis around the world is showing us that in India, at least, we know that about 12 crore people have already lost their jobs around the month of April. Oh. And people are still on the verge of losing jobs. There's the constant statistics that is increasing. And now again, if I go back to the first answer I gave you, a lot of this is causing stress and anxiety in people, right? Because naturally there's a financial liability. There are breadwinners in families. But this is my advice. And what I feel is job employment is definitely under threat. There is an issue currently. But instead of people asking the question, why me? Or how could my boss do this to me? Well, first and foremost, don't hold a grudge against your employer. The employer is also trying to make ends meet currently. And they're looking at their interest. You've got to look for yours. Okay. So looking out for your interest, one of the things a person needs to ask themselves when they're facing a job threat or are on the brink of unemployment is, how do I move forward next? What's my next step? Right? Chances are people are also stuck in the wrong job. They're in those jobs because there is a paycheck coming in end of the month, right? So maybe this is that moment where you are kind of giving yourself a chance to, or you're getting a chance from the universe to push yourself out of that cage and actually find your true calling. So it may sound dreamy, but I feel people need to work on their skills currently to stay in the job sector. They have to up their skills. They have to work on bringing something to the table which they don't already have. Another thing is you have to keep a positive mindset. You cannot blame your employer or hold grudges or sit in stress and anxiety, because if you're worrying, you cannot work. And if you're working, you don't need to worry. So that's the whole concept. And one has to keep their mentality of growth going. So I think everybody who's facing that kind of threat, I understand, I can't fathom. It's quite a bit, you know, to have to go through that kind of a turmoil. But look for the opportunity in your adversity. You will find an opportunity. Don't sit down and brood. Work on a skill. Do something to increase your skill set, even if you've lost your job. It's a way to really make sure that the next time you do a job, you can find something that interests you at the same time pays you well. So it's going to take some time, but you know, we all live on hope. So find opportunity in adversity. That's what I would say.
Fantastic. Finding opportunity in adversity and skilling up is the best thing. Skilling up could be right. The idea. Fantastic.
Right.
So, and also let's talk about a lot of negativity is going around. The media is bombarding us with a lot of negative information. Of course, they are doing their job, and people are sad, disappointed, unhappy. So, can happiness be achieved even through these trying times? That will be my third question for this segment.
Okay. How do you achieve happiness? What's your ultimate goal? I'm asking you. What's your ultimate goal in life?
My goal?
Normal people.
My goal? I work with other experts and help them become extraordinary. So that would be my goal. And there are a couple others. Yeah, absolutely. Thank you.
Wonderful. So Ram, most people, when you're talking to them, you will notice when you ask them, what's your ultimate goal and what do you want to achieve in life? They will tell you that when I grow old, you go to any business honcho, you meet any individual, you meet a homemaker, you meet a student. I want to grow old. I want to be peaceful and I want to be happy. Now, what they don't realize, and that's the question I ask them back, is why not now? Why are you waiting till you turn a 65 or a 70 to be peaceful and happy when you have medical ailments? You'll have another reason to be, a little turmoil at that point. There'll be something else bothering you at that point. So why not happy? And that is exactly the answer to your question here. Happiness is not an objective. It's not a goal. It's a state of mind. You can go through all kind of difficulties and challenges with a state of mind which is not taking you through negativity, which is taking you in that zone where you're positive, where you're channelizing your thoughts, where you're picking the good, you know. You mustn't leave the bad, but happiness is something that does not need to be achieved. It's a state of mind. You and me could be having troubles while we speak right now. But if we know the form of being happy from within and taking up the challenges, I think that is what it's going to always be. So anybody who's seeking happiness at a certain point in life, they're making the biggest mistake of their life, because that's not going to happen. And they need to start looking within. Happiness is something that needs to come from within. It is something that you can work for, you know. It's a conscious effort. It's a conscious effort. So if you wake up in the morning and you're smiling, even if you don't have a reason to, but you know, I'm going to have a good day. You know, I'm going to make the most of my day. That's a form of setting the temperature for your day. If you are talking to your spouse and you've had a little bit of an argument and you say, you know what, I'm going to let this go because I'm not leaving my spouse. My spouse is not leaving. So I don't want to waste my day on this. So I personally feel if people, you know, understand the importance of just consciously making an effort on a daily basis to change their state of mind to happiness, things will change for them. It's not something you're going to achieve any later in life. It's got to be today.
Fantastic, fantastic. Well said. This happiness has to be brought from within. So you are responsible for your happiness. So you can't blame anybody else for making you unhappy. Is that right? Absolutely.
Absolutely, absolutely. And yes, we look for a lot of validation around us, just to add to that. So we're looking for people to appreciate us, and their appreciation makes us happy. But till you don't start looking at yourself in the mirror and considering your own value and your own worth, people are not going to value you. And once you know your own value, you won't care if people value you. So you have more reasons to be happy, you know.
Absolutely, absolutely. And viewers, one interesting resource that came to my mind as Zarina was speaking about happiness is a book that I read a few years ago called The Happiness Advantage. It's a fantastic book. If you want to go find out, that book is available maybe online, offline somewhere. The Happiness Advantage, buy and read that book. Let's, now with that, we have come to the second segment of this show, where I would like, Zarina, for you to share maybe one or two pieces of advice or insights or one or two tips for our viewers today about your topic.
Okay, sure. So the first little piece of advice I'd like to give everybody around is, you can have a bad moment. You can have a bad few hours, but you do not need to have a bad day. You know, something's going wrong with you. Yeah, something's going wrong with you. What happens is, until and unless there's a demise or there's a natural calamity or there is some, you know, real burden on your shoulders, you still can find a way to have a few good moments in a day. You have 24 hours. It is unimaginable and absolutely pitiful if you waste it, because you don't know how many more days you have, and you've got to make the most of what you have. So the least you can do is, it's not like I'm asking you to suddenly make enough money or suddenly be all famous or suddenly live the life that other people are living. But I'm asking you to just consider that, hey, I'm feeling bad. Something wrong has happened. But you know what? It's a bad moment. I'll deal with it. But I can't have a bad day. My day is not going to get spoiled. So that is one piece of advice. I personally practice it on a daily basis. And that's why usually people ask me, you don't have problems in your life. And my usual answer is, my problems are getting solved while solving other people's problems. So I'm pretty happy in my space, you know. So have a bad few moments, have a bad hour, bad few hours, but not a bad day. That should be your daily goal. And the other piece of advice I would give is, stop comparison. Your lives are meant to be yours. You are not part of a rat race. And for that, my simple explanation is that you are not a rat. And there is no race. There is no one line we are all running. So there is no need for you to judge yourself and be part of this comparative rat race. Just live your life and give your 100% to yourself. Make yourself feel good. Make yourself evolve each day. And have the confidence to detach from what the world is doing while you're pursuing your focus. That's it. So those are my two little pieces of advices for your audience.
Thank you so much. Amazing, amazing. It's worthwhile. And also, these are the little insights, probably, that an actionable piece of advice, I would say. Thank you for sharing. And which brings us to the third segment of this show, where I would like you to share a resource, a key resource, I would say, or a piece of software, or some resource that you think is available for our viewers today, so that they can go check it out and make use of. What would that be?
Okay. Can I give you two if that's okay?
Sure.
Or does it have to be one? Okay. So one I would suggest if, you know, I do the empowering series like you mentioned, and the empowering series is really, really interesting for people who would like to listen to a podcast. We have different guests, lots of inspirational stories, lots of different ways of dealing with challenges, and the Monday Mantras, which is basically a 5-7 minute quick fix to your day, right? So I personally would like people to give a shot to that as a resource. And the other one would be The Power of Now, this book I really like by Eckhart Tolle, if you've heard of it or read it. I think The Power of Now, because right now, that's all we have. We have now. We have this pandemic around us. We don't know what's next. A lot of things are uncertain. And uncertainty brings us to feel fear. And that leads to your stress, anxiety, and unhappiness and whatnot. So focus on the power of now. Focus on what you can do with your now. And I think life won't be as bad as we sometimes make it out to be.
Absolutely. And Eckhart Tolle must be right here on my background. I have that book.
Oh, wow. He's a good author.
Absolutely. He is good. And my job, another area of my work is in publishing. So I help people create and publish their books. So I'm very, an avid reader, I would say, and also a writer. And I also work with other authors. Eckhart Tolle is one of my favorite authors. And his book that you suggested is amazingly good. Like it's been recommended by so many people. Fantastic. Thank you so much, Zarina, for taking your time off from your busy schedule and getting on the show and sharing your insights, your perspectives, and your piece of advice and the resources as well. Thank you so much for joining us. And viewers, please go and find out Zarina's podcast and also check those podcasts and listen to those podcasts as well. And I'm sure she's bringing other guests on her show as well. So thank you, Zarina. Thank you once again for joining us on the show. New way of saying bye.
Thank you. Yeah, I think so. New way of saying bye. And thank you so much, Ram, for having me. It was wonderful to have this chat with you. And all the very best to you. And keep inspiring people as you are. I think it's a wonderful idea to have Live Limitless and people actually making a difference. You are taking such great efforts. And kudos to you for just being the flag bearer of something so great. So congratulations and all the best.